Okay, hello again guys for another video of Survivor Chaos. Today we're gonna play with Draenei against a very famous players. One of them are Kyrian, Kyrian Tor. Everyone knows this guy. So he's playing with the Dark Horde. Okay, we picked the major placement, so we will have a Phantom. And he, it seems, upgraded one tier 1 spell, melee damage, as we like us. Okay, we couldn't see. Okay, 25, 25, there is no gold mine next to us, it's fine. Right, so the Bandarian's here, and Sarok. Okay, nice, we will manage to push these enemies. That's good news. But this is nice. Tier 2 here. Probably he will upgrade tier 2 against me here. No, not yet. Okay, he upgraded the other side. He took the fortification. Tier 2 replacement by the Sarok, and tier 2 replacement by the Vanda as well. Alright, let's go tier 2 in the other side lane. Insufficient gold. Alright, he took the damage. He's planning to upgrade now, yep. And definitely he's going to push me back. Right, let's have some armor. Research. Lumber mill. We live next to the lumber mill, which is good. Yeah, he will push me back.
Research finished.
This with this pattern, we will stay, we will capture these two neutral buildings for a long time.
Research.
mid lane. Only threat that we will have in middle lane is Syscox. He's the only assassin hero that is powerful enough to prevent us from controlling mid lane. Very essential that we don't use any units here, but I think we should buy one range. It's fine. Alright, let's just buy one more. He's tier 3 in mid lane. Alright, maybe Carrion said, yeah, the dragons and hero in mid lane. He will control the mid lane for from this Star Rock, so we need tier 2 of ourselves. So we need to go. It depends, really. We can go tier 3 here. Let's go tier 3. Thank you. Nice. He will keep sending heroes to defend this T3. Maybe he will send another a hero for the coming wave that we're gonna send.
Insufficient gold.
Let's put here too. We should go T3 everywhere. Yeah, that was predictable, to be honest. Okay. We lack armor. Need to just keep upgrading.
Research finished.
We'll slowly push this.
Research finished.
Yeah, with dragons as well. So it's not gonna be hard this time to defend. Let's have the devotion aura. Need to hold this lane a little bit. Okay, let's redirect if we can. These dragons are just too OP. We need tier 3 here as well. Need to be careful again in top side lane. Let's send this guy just to level up and control the mid lane. Alright, so he will keep sending heroes. We're gonna lose the middle fight. We can steal that hero. No. But this is gonna be the last tier 2 unit we spawned here. Okay, go tier 3.
Research.
Oh guy is objective based. I'm not sure why he's hitting the barracks. We kill him. No, we did not. So let's keep upgrading. We need that. We need just to keep upgrading. There's no way we can hold mid lane. Crystallization, it's not really important for now.
Research finished.
Again, he's tier 2 and sending hero. We cannot kill that hero or any other heroes.
Research.
You need to drain Carrion from the mana. We want to do the same as well.
Research finished. Research finished. Insufficient gold.
Seems that we are good enough for killing heroes now. Alright, he's tier 3. I hope he will lose that hero and we're gonna form a bigger wave. I think he will survive. channel. He's hitting the barracks. Alright, at least we are holding this lane. Right, Nimnok, I guess Nimnok gonna push. He's a stronger hero. That's a little bit down.
Research finished.
Okay. All right, let's have that. Hit both these two waves. Is this sudden P4? If it's a sudden P4, which is fine. We'll go T4 as well, and if both two waves arrive at the same time, we're gonna use T4 spell. Yeah, it's T4.
Ale is my bare necessity.
The wave with Nimnok is less dangerous than this wave. So we will try to redirect Nimnok here and maybe, we can redirect the middle. Can they be redirected? Nope. Right, let's go tier 4.
I
think we should send our friend here. This is a tier 2 spell, which is going to be easy to do, eliminate. Took a lot of damage in this bottom barracks. And that was very hard to redirect. Yeah, I got the least gold because Kerian moves with heroes and tier 2 just too much. Excuse me, guys. I'm back. So let's see. All right, so need to do our moves here. He's trying to defend with tier 3.
Research finished.
I'll respect that. I'm gonna respect it. He's tier 4 now. We are really suffering because of because of this gold issue. Right, so let's send Adele here. Your two spell is indicated here. Gonna take any further damage. Yep. It's gonna be easy to defend for Bulgarian. Easy redirection as well. Yeah, it's starting to lag. We're not gonna lose our boy yet. Yeah, he will send, yeah, definitely Enlightened here. It's a very dangerous wave. Would send Adele immediately, but the problem which Kyrian is holding him there, or her, cannot tell who's he or her, or she, anything in this world. Well, let's send him. Controlling them. Hit the spell. Makes sense. So it's gonna be three heroes. He can smite, and if he smite, we lose. As simple as that. Kyrian is going to make me pay for my backstab. So, it's my turn to get sandwiched. I think we should send Velen top lane, and we should redirect Adal. Again, of course, this is all dependent on the lag. Yeah, as you can see, it's. It is very difficult to redirect. We cannot afford to wait for Kyrian to arrive. Again. Yeah, the game reached a level that my PC cannot tolerate. Maybe losing this barracks will improve the FPS. God, I cannot even click. I cannot see anything. The FPS is just too much. Yeah, the FPS are just very tough to handle here. Right, let's just suicide. Was really bad luck. If I managed to redirect him easily toward bottom, that would be fine. We could defend easily. But 6 FPS is unclickable. We should send Mathematic to defend this. He will take a lot of experience. Why the Banda are so passive here? Especially if the Bandarians manage to destroy this barracks, he would have a good chance to destroy this one. I am the Bandarians. I would It'd be very difficult to win this. Was not necessary. Why he did that, I'm not sure why. Can consent this wing here as well. Yeah, slowly pushing here. As I thought. So he got the Enlightened in the right side, but I think Carrion will keep his Enlightened big in his base. So it is a golden moment for Mr. Bandarian. He can eliminate one of his opponents. He can send Matamata into side lane. Carrion will be in danger here. Some of that was really indicated.
Taste the wrath of the Horde.
Easy to defend here. Nice redirection. Red must use smite. His two heroes are not good enough to hold this offense. Mm-hmm. that was a good move, a lucky move. He needs 6 cocks, he do a lot of damage. Incoming wave from mid lane. Carrion will send all of his forces against the Koreans. So Carrion will have a good offense here against the Pandarians. Yeah, Enlightened was eventual. He will smite it. It is actually unnecessary. The first smite was unnecessary at all. But let's see, maybe he's doing things in a different way. So, Red must use something here. He can actually double nuke this building. If he managed to double nuke this one, Carrion will be out of defense here. Not in bad position at all, Mr. Reyno. Reyno with a sovereign, okay. Six cocks is good. Yeah, he will easily beat this.
Thank you.
right, which is bad. Yeah, this is nukeable. Alright, nice defense by Mr. Reno. I didn't expect he will be enlightened. I thought it is in cooldown. Alright, this is two heroes, huge wave. Both of them are 28, so Matamata is needed. If he sends Matamata again in this side lane, he's gonna lose the game. He need to kill Red first. Might go right. Really? Yeah, Carrion took the momentum now. I think he can smite. Can he? Rex is under attack. He's not paying any attention here. This Barracks is under threat. I think Reno will have his enlightenment soon because he summoned both of them at the same time when Vendarion smited. So he will summon, Enlightened, indeed. Full mana. I think it is red game. Surviving. Thank you. he's going mid. Nice. Nice redirection. Nice timing. Nice way of defending this, Mr. Lightning. Red managed to defend this beautifully. Again, come on. This guy is doing a random play. This is a random play. Maybe only Matamata he got, maybe, not sure. But this is a random play. Doesn't have any. Any benefit from attacking Carrion right now, and Carrion definitely gonna get smited. Aware of that, that's why he's trying to. Get to spell, nice. How can he defend the right side? Might now if you want. Silent is a problem now. Yeah, Red definitely deserve it. Matamata is just doing his job here. don't think he got more units, but I think he can redirect him by redirect this wave by attacking this Mathmata with his barracks. He can redirect. Alright, Syscox with the Lighten is dirty work. I need to buy a new PC. A new laptop maybe, new gaming laptop. Alright, so let's see, did we? No! Mama, no! Oh no! So now Kyrian must rely on men to be cruel. Which is impossible. The emotion aura. Gonna last forever. Maybe you should repair this with the bonus. Didn't repair for a long time. It seems that Doomed is not gonna help him here, but But he will win eventually. Kerrion got the chance, he can send Deathwing a bit lane. Deathwing is horrible super unit. So, would he send mid? Yes, but it goes mid. Alright, okay, mid, good, good. If he managed to destroy this barracks, then he will have a chance again. Save that tier 2 spell instead of sending him randomly like that. This is a nice duel. It's gonna be a tough time here defending this barracks. Nice range, summon at a good time. Nice redirection. Good redirection. Okay. hero mentor. They like you, don't fall. But I think he got still the twin game. Fair enough. Alright. Yeah, that was a wonderful game. Well done by Mr. Reno. We managed to win this with great strategies. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And always, thanks for watching.